Youth Sounds is brought to you by the Jamaica Baptist Union. It is a program of the Jamaica Baptist Union Youth Department.
Oh my gosh, it's Youth Sounds!
Youth Sounds!
Hey, this is Vice. I'm here representing what? Youth Sounds.
Are Youth Sounds?
What do you mean by Youth Sounds?
Youth Sounds.
Don't know it's Youth Sounds.
Youth Sounds.
Welcome back.
Sing that.
All right. So, the same crew. Oh, but if you never listened last week,
You missed out
a whole lot.
Yeah, well, then can go back in the last week and listen again.
YouTube.
Because remember, we're there on YouTube.
Yeah.
And we're there on Blue. So, no, nobody can go on Blue.
Say it properly. It's not YouTube, it's YouTube.
Okay, yes. You alone, Grace.
Okay, Alistair. Okay. It's YouTube.
Yeah, actually, you said you cannot chip out there.
Yeah.
Proceed.
Yes. Vice, you're there again.
Yeah, man, that's Vice.
Natalie is here with us once again.
Yeah.
And we're going to continue our discussion that you missed. Make sure you tune in to YouTube.
Youth Sounds.
Yeah, that one. So last week we spoke about Christmas morning.
Christmas Eve.
Why we keep on saying Christmas? Grand Market.
True.
Can we are talking about this Christmas
it's
Eve?
It's Christmas Eve slash Grand Market.
But if you know, if you grow up a country, you never have Grand Market. You have merry-go-round.
What?
What?
Really? We never have merry-go-round.
No. What?
Yes, and we did have merry-go-round with ice cream, man.
Is
and
this some in Jamaica?
Yes.
Is that very part of Jamaica? It's not Ochorios.
Mm-mm. Clarendon. Mm-mm.
Which part of Clarendon?
Which part of Clarendon that?
Brandon Hill?
They're that here?
Yeah, man. We have merry-go-round.
I need to contact somebody from Brandon Hill and find out about this merry-go-round.
Yeah, man.
I mean, you never had a merry-go-round.
One of the things that we forgot to say, though, in terms of what used to happen on Christmas Eve, as I look our Christmas Day in the evening, is that I don't know about you. I used to go different persons also. When I finish with my family.
Oh, stop! I'm
hey,
hey,
I'm going for my auntie.
Yes.
I'm by my bum, my belly, and my auntie. I'm going to link one of my friends. Hey,
we are. You have to walk off the food.
I'm going to fire one them first. So you know, right. So by me, wish don't say belly. We're off.
Yes.
So I'm wire to more food there, so I'm wire here, so when we done,
yes.
Before belly full till next week.
Unbelievable.
May I tell you?
Unbelievable.
That's true.
Christmas.
For real.
Christmas, so, you eat one meal where you never eat before.
Mm-hmm. Christmas is not Christmas without gungo rice and beef.
Oh,
true.
God.
Mm-hmm.
And it have to cook on wood fire. Come, I don't know if it's the smoke or what.
Different taste.
Cold fire for me was the pork. Like mother have a cold pot outside.
Eh?
Yeah, man, and she have the pork and cook them well nice.
Yeah,
and earn that day, baking sweat upon it next and tender.
I know, original Baptist, you know. Mm-hmm. Christmas meal means they have more than one version of
exactly.
Pork.
Oh, yeah.
Because they ham different from the sea pork.
All right.
Yeah, man.
That's true.
Yeah, man. And if you're a man shopping that morning, you eat like a corn pork, too.
Yeah.
With Aki. With Aki.
You eat some heavy breakfast.
Yeah, man. My yard, we make sure we have pot roast pork, we have stew pork, and if the Lord rain on his blessing, we definitely have to have ham.
Yeah. Ham!
Oh,
no,
it's some pineapple.
Yeah, man.
Ooh. You see the straight call ham, what's ham and the chicken and the beef and the fish.
Mm-hmm. All right, so the cow have a life after Christmas. That is definitely.
Yes.
But you see any pig where they're nearby? Must start fret from December.
Every pig a fret, man.
Yeah, man.
Pig
must start feed him extra.
What?
You know?
Him up.
Whereas if you want to keep away, you have a relative that farm, and probably all earlier, like all January, the pig have a couple of piglets, and everybody get a piglet, and, oh, that's my little piggy over there, Billy. And then Christmas, you eat up your ham, and so what happened to Billy?
Billy
on the table.
Jesus. Billy.
You don't cry, no. You cry because it tastes good, but you're disappointed that it had to be Billy. But somebody had to go.
Somebody had to go.
That is sacrificial living.
Yeah.
It's true.
The pig sacrifices his life.
Yeah, man.
Especially especially around Christmas time. Yeah. For the betterment of the people.
You're here with them?
Oh, yes.
Christmas dinner can't go on without chicken. We can't figure
of
it out.
Of course.
Yeah, man. Yeah. We can't figure it out.
You eat chicken almost every day before that.
Where mackerel go? Sardine. What's happening? They make something for a week, October.
No, that's a New Year's dinner. Sardine. Yes. Mackerel.
New Year's dinner for
Christmas. Yeah, man. Christmas took all the money.
That's true.
Yeah, man. Christmas.
You feast today and famine tomorrow.
Feast today and famine tomorrow.
Everybody spend out January.
New Year's breakfast.
You go back to figure school.
Just like when you walk free food, you walk
exactly.
free
bag. You're good to at least 1 week after Christmas.
Exactly.
Yeah. But this week that we eat now, yeah, man, Christmas food still a carry on.
Yeah, man. And then we were seeing January morning. January
and you saw rush on the pork. Yeah. And then when, you saw rush on the ham, man. So every day you eat ham for breakfast.
Yeah.
And then it come down when you know have not left on the ham bone Saturday. The
ham
Saturday
bone after soup.
Ham bone
soup.
Yeah, man.
The
worst thing as a school student, when you go back to school, you know, January morning, your parents spend out all the money them pa nice dish. Make sure you get the best. The best food for Christmas. When you look at the same old boat, you're going back to school.
Just the worst thing. The worst of it.
Yeah, man, I'm polished.
I think I enjoyed Christmas a lot, but I always was bothered by the fact that because my birthday come like a week and something after Christmas, I'm always here. No, man, your Christmas present at your birthday.
Oh, no!
And that used to happen to my little brother, you know, because his birthday is the 24th. Mm. You see, Christmas. So if you're getting a gift, you're going to get it all in one.
Oh, jeez.
Never let it all in one thing. Still don't like it.
Thank God I'm born in February.
But I couldn't do that with mommy and daddy because their anniversary is the 23rd.
Of December?
Yes.
Wow.
So them anniversary the 23rd, my little brother's birthday the 24th, and we have Christmas the 25th. I'm like,
too much.
Wrap
the clock.
Wrap the clock. No, take the hand them out of the clock and wrap that. And then wrap the clock and make them home before Christmas.
So like I think I'm going to do that for this.
So like
up. Or even the hook. You wrap the hook and the nail we're going to go.
Yeah, so I'm going to do that for this Christmas. Wait, I hope they don't listen to that one because I know one they know sad.
No.
It's supposed to, alright, man. It's supposed to, alright.
But
New Year's,
though. I used to look forward to New Year's, you know. Well, maybe New Year's not so much a watch night. Because I used to love watch, like, on TV. When I came and you just watch them, all these whole people in Times Square. And they come, 5, 4, 3, 2, Happy New Year, everybody.
I always wonder about that. So I went, one year I went to Bermuda. And just like how they have the ball drop, in New York, they have an onion drop. Because that is, you know, like how New York is a big apple. Something about onions for them.
The big onion.
Me no know. Or the little onion. Me no know. But I always said, boy, we couldn't have an Aki drop of Jamaica. Yeah, man, like one giant Aki. And everybody meet a halfway tree if you watch the Aki drop.
And it couldn't be a big bulla drop too.
Yeah, man!
That's what I said.
Bulla drop or ham drop. The ham drop.
With the pineapple.
You know my weird sound? For New Year's, I used to have my watch. It was like a digital watch. Me used to say, I'll wait to see the time actually go from 11 to 12 o'clock and then see the day change at the same time. That was a weird thing, Mr. Isaac. I'm not sure. Yeah, man, hallelujah. Hey, man, you're going to do it. You do it. That was weird like that, sorry.
You know, you can do that every night, though.
It's weird.
It's not the same. You see the day and the year change.
Right throughout the season, though, the things that stick with you are how you interact as family. Because for me, watch night service, you're there and even every pastor is different. Some preach right up until midnight. Some break a little before so you can do the countdown and the singing. But remember, no matter what was going on, if it's meet and greet or we're sitting in the sermon, my father used to always lean over and him hold him watch and me and him do a little countdown and we whisper to each other. So you remember those little things.
Wow. That's
so sweet. When daddy up there preaching, you know, I mean, I said, all right, watch your time. All right. You can't cut the sermon. And he finally cut it. He said, good. We have one like 5 minutes before. Then he said, prayer. And he would have asked the person who prayed the longest. And I'm I mean, what? I said, good. Yeah. And in Jesus' name, and you think them are going to say amen, then start something. I'm going to say, no, at 12 o'clock, a new year.
11:59, and then 12 o'clock, the pack is the full arrest. Yeah, church has ever been. Yeah. Yeah. Some people just yeah. run through the door.
Because just,
the altar.
Just in case God will come just at that case. Point in time.
I you're am going, there.
You're there, yeah. just in case.
But 12:01, church God. Empty.
What? No, yeah. no, 12:01 the party ram.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Everybody gonna dance.
And you know the other good thing about New Year's, everybody gets a hug. No matter yes. who it is, everybody oh. gets a hug. Mm-hmm. New Year's night.
Them time that Christmas, New Year's, best time of the year. Hey, I start countdown. But wait, for Christmas, from like about the 2nd of January.
Me starting.
No, you take it too far.
From the beginning of November, me starting around.
Take it too far.
But we're ready for New Year's this year. Ready for 2018.
You know, hold on. Guess who walk in?
Sir Bouginis himself.
Yeah. Andre.
Andre this?
Yes, it's Andre. He looks bright like Christmas tree.
Andre, have you got an interview?
You look pretty.
Shine bright,
well,
diamond.
Well,
diamonds don't really shine though, that's what it
is. Uncle Andre.
I digress.
If you want catch making call.
If you know what I'm
talking. Hi, Andre.
Hi, Andre.
Come say something to
the people. Andre.
Give the people them Christmas greetings.
Oh, that's what we're doing.
That's what we're doing.
Oh. Yeah, I'm team, man. It look like him popped down.
Tell us about your Christmas. How
yes,
was Christmas?
What about yes?
How your was interview. Your
How was your Christmas?
How was my Christmas?
First of all, he looked 2 times as fat.
Wait.
So you had a healthy Christmas.
Did Santa give you a beard for Christmas?
Andre, how was your Christmas? I'm your only friend that
did. This is
I went and I visited some very good friends.
Pause. We just
friends.
Said, don't make nobody dry you out like shoes lace.
Don't make them dry you out. Don't make them dry you out tie your shoes lace.
Which is right.
Yeah, man.
Yes.
Continue.
Okay. So I went to some true friends.
Uh-huh.
You know, same as
for Christmas.
Yes.
I guess I can call a name. I went over to the Mighties for Christmas. And I emceed a concert in Trelawney.
Yeah. He did caroling too?
Oh. No.
No caroling.
The voice wasn't there to do it.
Because, like me?
Because of conference and rally and convention, the voice didn't come back, and then there was choral service at work and then cantata, church and all of that. So the voice was just
You're
not 100.
Him.
Yes.
Yeah, very active.
Yeah.
Some people have a happy
New
Year.
Happy New Year.
Yeah. And look forward to your New Year. And a New Year resolution, something. If you're going to set one, nobody break it like the first week after you set it.
You can share with us on Facebook or Instagram.
Or YouTube.
Or YouTube what your New Year's resolution is for 2018.
And if you don't know where to share, yeah, JBU.
Happy New Year! Sounds is brought to you by the Jamaica Baptist Union. It is a program of the Jamaica Baptist Union Youth Department.